coming in at 6 inches or just under 6 inches or 15 centimeters, Ayla Secura gets her Black Series debut and she looks fantastic. Here she is next to Commander Cody. We'll see more of him later on. In terms of the packaging, she is pretty basic stuff as usual in the main line, Attack of the Clones. We get some nice artwork on the side. Doesn't really look quite like the actress. Love the little dome ship there from Attack of the Clones on that. Not quite sure what she was doing on Geonosis, but never mind. She's obviously fighting in the Clone Wars. There we go. So some text on the back. Now, despite the artwork not looking really like the actress, the figure does. So number 3 in Attack of the Clones. And here we go. Let's have a little bit of a zoom in. And it looks pretty nice. Looks really quite nice overall. Now, for some reason, a lot of dudes go really crazy about Leku as if, I don't know quite what's going on. But she's very popular in the Star Wars universe with a lot of males. And she looks great, so I can understand that. Comes with a very long hilted lightsaber, which has, if we twist that around, a little peg there, and that peg plugs into the belt there if you wanted to do that. Let me just, without taking the lightsaber out of the hilt, which you totally can do, it would plug in and fit on the belt as such. So it does look good. Very nice indeed. She's got some fabulous looking sculpting going on. The leather looks really good under all these flaps and bits and pieces. 'Tis always about the flaps on Star Wars stuff. Leku kind of get in the way for some poses. You could move them around if you wanted a little bit. It's kind of stretching it. But yeah, there you go. You can get a little bit of posing if you wanted to, whatever's up to you, but generally speaking, you'll have her like that or that. There's not going to be a great deal of range of motion, but the leather looks particularly good. It looks very well sculpted. There's a lot of nice leathery detail around it there. Very different tonal kind of difference. Well, that almost looks like a kind of snake skin, whereas this looks like leather here. So it's nicely done. It's very well sculpted. And she's blue, obviously, and one little belly button. So yeah, right down to her kind of trademark booties that we saw in the 3.75-inch version many years ago. Still got pins for a new figure, which is kind of weird, but never mind. But pinless arms. So, in terms of articulation, she's got that ball joint on that head, which again, never really gave a proper close-up just to really, really show you. Beautifully done eyes, lips looks good, a little bit of sweaty lip going on, a little bit of sweaty plastic still. Hey ho, it is what it is. We talked about it on the 6 Inch Show episode 121 if you want to hear more about Sweaty Gate. So in terms of that head, as I mentioned, back and forth, and you got a little bit of tilting back and forth there. Arms on a ball joint up at the top, you can see there are no bicep swivel, single joint there, but it's pretty reasonably high angled. You have a swivel wrist, and also that goes up and down for Ayla on this hand. And on the other hand, it is exactly the same, up and down. So again, that ab crunch is really good. Plenty of range of motion movement. Pegs up at the top of the legs, which gives you a thigh swivel, which gives you a double joint of the knee, which, oh, boot cut too. Fancy, fancy schmancy. Down to rocking ankles and really deep pickles, which is great. So she looks good, and it's going to be a really popular figure. We'll put a link underneath the video if you're watching this on YouTube and you can pick it up, or if you're watching this on Amazon, then you can just go and buy it because it's there. Let us know what you think. Of course, you can buy this other places too, BBTS, Dorset Toys, all these places. Check them out. But that's it for me. We will see you for more figure reviews, Star Wars, G.I. Joe, Marvel Legends, and more. But Ayla Secura gets a thumbs up. Go buy one. See you soon.